In the PreTrig review part 3, we explore multiplying binomials and taking powers of binomials. Now, example A requires us to use the algebra rule that if you have quantity A minus B times quantity A plus B, then that will equal A squared minus B squared. So when we look at our example here, the first term is 5x, so we have to take that whole first term, 5x quantity squared, minus the second term, which is 2 squared. Now another rule from algebra that we're going to need is if you have quantity ab squared, then that equals a squared b squared. So then this first term here, quantity 5x squared, is going to equal 25x squared, and then minus 4. And that's our final answer. In the second example, we have a quantity being squared. So then the rule from algebra we're going to be using is a plus b quantity squared is equal to a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So when we apply that to this example, we have quantity 2x squared plus 2 times 2x times 7 plus 7 squared. And when we simplify these, we get 4x squared plus 2 times 2 is 4 times 7 is 28, so plus 28x plus 49. And that's our final answer for this one. In example C, we're using the rule quantity a minus b squared is equal to a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So we'll get the first term squared, so we have quantity 3y squared minus, sometimes we refer to this as twice the product, so we have to take twice 3y times 4, and then we have to square the second term, so we have 4 squared. And when we simplify this, we're going to get 9y squared minus 2 times 3 is 6 times 4 is 24y plus 16. Final answer. Now for part D and for part E, we want to make use of what's called Pascal's triangle. So let's remember how that works. If you start with a 1 at the top and you put 1s all along the outside diagonals, so the next row would be 1, and then what you do is add these two, so 1 plus 1 is 2, and then of course the last row is a 1. And the next row then would start with a 1. You add 1 and 2 to get 3. You add 2 and 1 to get 3. And then on the diagonal you have a 1. Now what these refer to are the coefficients when you expand a binomial. So for example, this is a plus b to the 0, and we know anything to the 0 power is 1. A plus b to the first power, which of course we know is a plus b. Now what the 1s are referring to here is that is the coefficient of the a term is a 1, and the coefficient of the b term is a 1. Now if we look at the third row, a plus b squared, we already know from our special products that that is a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. And the way you can use Pascal's triangle is, again, look at the coefficients. You have a 1 here that refers to the coefficient of the a squared being 1. The 2 here refers to the coefficient of the next term is a 2. And this 1 here tells you that the coefficient of the next term is a 1. So now, when we look at the fourth row, we have a plus b to the third, and that tells us that our coefficients are going to be 1, 3, 3, 1. So we're going to get 1a cubed plus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared plus 1, we're back here to this last coefficient is going to be a 1, b cubed. So now let's apply Pascal's triangle to quantity n plus 4 to the third power. So we're going to be using this row of Pascal's triangle, and we get the first coefficient is 1, and it's going to be n to the third plus. Our second coefficient will be 3, so we have 3 times n to the second times 4 to the first. That's what this term right here is telling us to do. Then the next term, right, our coefficient is going to be a 3, and the a exponent, as you can see, keeps decreasing. It was a to the third, then a to the second, now it's going to be a to the first, whereas the b exponent is increasing. It was essentially b to the 0, then b to the 1, b squared, b cubed. So in our case, we're working on this third term, so we know the coefficient is 3. We know that we have to take our first term to the first power and our second term to the second power. So our first term is n, and our second term is 4. And then finally, the last term will have a coefficient of 1, and you can see the exponent of the first term is 0, so it's essentially not there. And then we have b to the third power, so in our case, we're taking 4 to the third power. So when we simplify now, we have n to the third plus. Now the coefficient for the second term is going to be 3 times 4, which is 12. So we have 12 n squared plus. The coefficient for the third term is going to be 4 squared, which is 16, times 3, which is 48. So the term is 48n plus 4 to the third, which is 64. And that's our final answer. Now when we look at example E, it is also a cubic, but we have a minus sign in here that we have to pay attention to, but we're using that same row of Pascal's triangle. First coefficient is 1, and our first term has to be cubed, so we're taking 5y cubed. And then because of that minus sign, what happens in the expansion is every other sign is a negative. So the first sign is a positive, The next sign would be negative. The next sign would be positive. The next sign would be negative. So the signs alternate when there is a negative inside the binomial. So our first term was positive, which means our second term will be negative. Our second term has a coefficient of 3. So we put a 3 times 5y squared times 2. The next coefficient is a 3, and we see that we go back to positive, so plus 3 5y times 2 squared, and then the last coefficient is a 1, and in our alternating signs we're going to have a minus sign, so minus 1 times the second term cubed, and our second term is 2. Five to the third power, we know, is 125. So now we have 125y cubed minus the coefficient of this next term. We have to use our order of operations. So 5 squared is 25. 25 times 3 is 75. 75 times 2 is 150, and we have y squared plus, in this next term we have to do the 2 squared first, so that's 4. 4 times 5 is 20. 20 times 3 is 60, and the variable is y, minus 2 to the third, which is 8. And there's our final answer.